So my lab has been interested in normal B lymphocyte development and how this can go wrong towards the development of acute lymphoblastic leukemia. And a few years ago, we made a surprising discovery that phosphatases, inhibitory molecules that are important in negatively regulating signal strength, are important for the survival of B lymphoid leukemias. And that was very surprising to us, because the current thinking in the field is that to make a tumor more aggressive, it would need increase, not decrease, of signaling strength. And so in our observation, we found that these phosphatases are crucial to balance and to provide some equilibrium of oncogene signaling, and that, much unlike what the field is proposing in other areas, that blocking the negative regulators can be a quite powerful way of preventing relapse and overcoming conventional mechanisms of drug resistance in leukemia. B lymphocytes have to go through a number of developmental checkpoints during their development, and the expression and function of the so-called B cell receptor plays a major role in this. And this is also related to our main finding, that these inhibitory phosphatases are crucial in these checkpoints. And this is basically a quality control mechanism in which the functionality of B cell receptors are being tested. And outcomes of this checkpoint could be that the receptor works just fine. It's a strong, persistent signal that drives proliferation and survival. But other outcomes is that the receptor is not strong enough. In this case, the cells fall below a minimum threshold of survival signals. And now what we found is that it could also be the opposite. The signal is too strong, in which case the receptor is autoreactive, and this also leads to negative selection and cell death. So this is the vulnerability in leukemia that we identified and that we are now pursuing for therapeutic purposes. That's a great question. So the approach that we are pursuing is fairly new. In fact, probably we are, at City of Hope, the only group that is currently pursuing these therapeutic targets, because they don't fall in this mainstream category of signal inhibition. And from that point of view, it's probably too early to say whether we can find individual patient-specific vulnerabilities. What we can say, though, is that looking at different subtypes of leukemia, that they are not all the same. There are clearly differences in sensitivity in our preclinical models. We mostly work with mouse models in which we propagate patient-derived cells. So when we divide those into different subtypes of leukemia, we find clear differences in responsiveness to the therapeutics. It's basically feedback control of signal strength. So the observation was that normal B cells, but also B cell lineage leukemia cells, need to maintain equilibrium or need to maintain balance. So the specific targets in this case are inhibitory phosphatases. Some of them are called P10 or PTPN6 and DASP6. They have all similar functions by negatively regulating kinases that they are opposing. And so we have tested a number of small molecule inhibitors of these phosphatases, and currently my lab is in the process of making a direct agonist or activator of a central tyrosine kinase called SYK, spelled S-Y-K, which is the most proximal kinase in the B cell receptor signaling pathway.